Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you 6LOWPAN protocol with complete details. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll be covering basics of 6LOWPAN. After that, I'll explain you architecture of 6LOWPAN. Then I'll cover requirements of 6LOWPAN. After that, I'll explain you features of 6LOWPAN. Then I'll explain you protocol spec of 6LOWPAN. After that, I'll explain you advantages and disadvantages of 6LOWPAN. And at last, I'll explain you applications of 6LOWPAN. Let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of 6LOWPAN. What is 6LOWPAN? See, 6LOWPAN is IPv6 over low power wireless personal area network. So here, low power wireless personal area network that will be communicating with the use of IPv6 internet protocol. This low power wireless personal area network that we will be establishing with the use of IoT devices. IoT devices are functioning at low power. Here communication will be wireless. So with the use of IoT devices, low power wireless personal area network will be created, and that will be communicating over internet with the use of IPv6 protocol in 6LOWPAN. So 6LOWPAN combines the latest internet protocol IPv6 and low power wireless personal area network. Here 6LOWPAN allows smallest device with limited processing ability to transmit information wirelessly on internet using IPv6 protocol. See here, IoT devices will be having limited processing ability. You will be having embedded system, right? So IoT devices are having limited processing ability. It will be transmitting information wirelessly on internet with the use of IPv6 protocol, right? See, 6LOWPAN is low cost protocol. We use it for short range. Here memory usage that is very less. Here data transfer will be happening at low bit rate. It comprises of edge router and sensor nodes. I'll show you that in architecture, that will give you more clarity, right? See, using 6LOWPAN, the smallest of IoT devices can be a part of the network and talk to the outside world. For example, if you have LED street lights, then LED street lights can communicate on internet with the use of 6LOWPAN protocol, right? So smallest of IoT devices can even communicate on internet. Let me show you architecture over here, so that will give you more clarity. See here, first we will be creating low power wireless area network, right? And that is what we are creating with the use of IoT devices. And that network will be mesh network. Mesh network means all the nodes. See, these are the nodes, these are IoT devices. All the IoT devices are connected with each other, right? Now this network, which is low power wireless personal area network, that will be communicating wirelessly with edge router. So here there will be edge router to which wireless communication will happen, right? And this communication will happen with the use of IPv6 protocol. And see, this edge router can transfer data on cloud with the use of wired or wireless communication, right? So here there will be cloud, one can say internet. So on server, on cloud, we will be transferring data, right? From server, any user can access the data. But here we are creating low power wireless personal area network with the use of IoT devices. And that is forming mesh network. From this node, we can transfer data wirelessly. And that wireless communication that will happen as per IEEE 802.15.4. Right. And then edge router will be receiving that data. Here data format will be as per IPv6 protocol. And then that data will be transferred on cloud. This transfer of data can be wired or wireless. Wired can be there with the use of Ethernet protocol. Wireless can be there as per Wi-Fi protocol. Right. Here data transfer will happen as per TCP UDP protocol. Right. So 6LOWPAN technology makes individual nodes IP enabled. So here individual nodes are there. as per IoT devices that will be provided with IP address as per IPv6, right? And this IPv6 address with individual nodes can transfer data wirelessly to edge router. So one can say 6LOWPAN technology makes individual nodes IP enabled, right? Edge router is the core of 6LOWPAN network. So this edge router, that is intermediary node, that one can say it is a core of this 6LOWPAN network. The reason is this network will be having limited area, right? This edge router is providing wide range of communication on internet. So every time these nodes will be communicating with edge router for internet communication, right? So edge router connects 6LOWPAN network with the internet. See, 6LOWPAN can communicate with ZigBee devices. So here these nodes can be having ZigBee devices, means ZigBee protocol will be there as per IEEE 802.15.4, or these nodes can be having Wi-Fi as per IEEE 802.11. 6LOWPAN is using AES 128. AES is Advanced Encryption Standard, and this is providing security layer, right? So 6LOWPAN uses AES 128 security layer, right, which is already defined in IEEE 802.15.4, and it provides authentication and encryption. So for security purpose, AES 128 layer, that is already integrated with this 6LOWPAN protocol, and that is what we are integrating along with the data transmission. So data transmission will be having authentication as well as encryption. So security is also provided to all these nodes, right? Now I'll explain you requirements of 6LOWPAN. See, devices must have sleep mode to support battery saving. So whatever devices which we use it in 6LOWPAN, that should be having sleep mode. As if it is having sleep mode, then battery saving is possible, right? So that is first requirement. Second is minimal memory requirements are there. Minimal memory requirements are there. Here you don't need to have humongous memory, right? See, RAM requirement, that could be around 16 KB, and ROM can be there around 128 KB. So that is quite minimal right now in 2023. Nowadays, minimum data is available in terms of MB with RAM and ROM with the devices, right? See, routing overhead, that will be lower over here, right? Why? The reason is here we are dealing with to have low cost application where data transfer rate will be less. So overhead should be lower over here with 6LOWPAN. Here devices should be having lower computation, right? As we are dealing with to have low cost application, so devices will be having lower computation. So requirement in terms of computation is very less over here with 6LOWPAN. Now let me discuss about features of 6LOWPAN. See, it is used with IEEE 802.15.4 ZigBee protocol. So here when it comes to physical layer, at that time it uses this protocol which we use it in ZigBee, right? And that is communicating with the frequency of 2.4 GHz, that is ISM band. ISM means industrial scientific medical band, that is free for any user. So as if any user wants to access this frequency, then that user will not have to purchase frequency. It is unlicensed band, that one can say. So all the users are allowed to use this frequency, which comes under ISM band. So this protocol functions with this IEEE standard, which is functioning wirelessly at frequency of 2.4 GHz. Maximum outdoor range, that is around 200 meter. For 6LOWPAN, here maximum data rate, that is around 200 kbps, so that data rate is very low, one can say that. But here our agenda is to have low cost applications. See, maximum nodes for this low power wireless personal area network is 100 nodes, right? So 100 nodes can be connected in 6LOWPAN network, right? Now I'll explain you protocol stack for 6LOWPAN. See, when it comes to protocol stack, then first of all you'll have to see what are the protocol which is there with physical layer. Here at physical layer we will be having wireless communication, that wireless communication happens at IEEE 802.15.4, which is a similar protocol which we use it in ZigBee, right? At data link layer, we have same protocol, IEEE 802.15.4. Here media access control, that is done as per CSMACA. CSMACA means carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. For that also, I have made separate video in the lecture series of computer network. See, third layer is network layer. In network layer, we are having IPv6 protocol. This protocol is used for IP address assignment, and RPL protocol that is used for routing. So here routing protocol for lossy network is happening, and this RPL protocol that we use it for IoT applications, right? Then at transport layer, we use TCP and UDP protocol. TCP is for secured connection, and UDP that is used for connection less services. Here security is provided as per TLS and DTLS. At application layers, various protocols are supported over here with 6LOWPAN. HTTP, COAP, MQTT and WebSocket, these are the protocol which we use it at application layer. See, in this video lecture series of IoT, I'll be explaining you these protocols in great details. Right now, just consider these are the protocols that we use it with respect to different layers, right? RPL is already covered in this video lecture series of IoT, right? Now, advantages of 6LOWPAN. There are many advantages. See, 6LOWPAN is a mesh network, and that is robust, scalable and self-healing. 6LOWPAN delivers low cost and secured communication in IoT devices. 6LOWPAN uses IPv6 protocol so that data can be routed directly to the cloud. For internet communication, IPv6 protocol is assigned in 6LOWPAN. 6LOWPAN offers one-to-many and many-to-one routing. So here one-to-many means from edge node, edge router to many nodes communication is possible, as well as many nodes which are IoT devices can communicate with edge router. Right, so one to many and many to one routing is happening with this 6LOWPAN protocol. 6LOWPAN works efficiently with open IP standards like TCP, UDP, COAP, HTTP, MQTT and WebSocket. All these standards that we use it with 6LOWPAN protocol, right? See, for power saving, leaf nodes can stay in sleep mode for longer duration. So here, because of sleep mode, we can have efficient power saving with IoT devices. 6LOWPAN offers large network which can be used by millions of IoT devices. 6LOWPAN doesn't need gateway. With the use of edge router, data can be routed to the cloud. One should know, when it comes to data communication, at that time cost of gateway is high, right? In LoRaWAN, I have explained you functions of gateway, as well as on gateway, I have made a separate video. Cost of gateway, that is way high compared to router. Here in 6LOWPAN protocol, we are using edge router for a communication to the internet, right? Now let us discuss disadvantages. 6LOWPAN is less secured than ZigBee. See, ZigBee devices that we use it in 6LOWPAN network, right? But still, overall 6LOWPAN protocol that is less secured compared to ZigBee protocol. See, when it comes to immunity to interference, then 6LOWPAN is less immune compared to Wi-Fi and Bluetooth devices. See, here we are communicating wirelessly. In Bluetooth, we are having frequency hopping spread spectrum. So wireless communication is immune to the interference in Bluetooth devices, right? Here 6LOWPAN protocol that is less immune compared to Wi-Fi and Bluetooth devices, right? See, 6LOWPAN protocol supports short range without mesh topology. In a creation of LOWPAN, low power wireless personal area network, if you don't use mesh topology, then range will get further reduced in 6LOWPAN protocol, right? Now let us discuss about applications of 6LOWPAN. See, 6LOWPAN that is widely used in smart meters and smart grid. These two applications are widely used in Canada as well as in US with the use of 6LOWPAN protocol. But still there are many other applications like home automation, smart agriculture and industrial monitoring. So that is how complete detail is available over here based on 6LOWPAN. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.